Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, formerly known as Lew Alcindor before he changed his name in 1971. Kareem has a strong and extensive case to be the NBA's greatest player of all time. He's the NBA's all-time leading scorer with over 38,000 points, 6 MVPs, and 6 NBA championships. He was one of the best scorers year in and year out. He was an elite defender with 11 all-defense team selections. He was an elite rebounder and was known as the captain during the Lakers dynasty days of the 1980s. Unfortunately, Kareem very rarely receives the credit he deserves when discussing the greatest players of all time. Despite his otherworldly production, Kareem had a very modest personality. Magic Johnson was the flashy, charismatic one with the fast break and the no-look passes, while Kareem was slower paced, more about fundamentals and routine. Many, including myself, strongly believe this is the reason Kareem rarely gets his well-deserved shine. It's the same reason everyone wants to talk about Kobe and his 5 championships, but no one wants to talk about Tim Duncan and his 5 championships. It's because one had a flashy personality and a flashy game, while the other was the quiet but reliable type. We simply don't praise both styles of players equally. Magic, Kareem, Kobe, and Tim Duncan will all produce on a regular basis, but it's Kobe and Magic who make the highlight reels, while Kareem's skyhook and Duncan's bank shots only show up on the stat sheet. Kareem was so incredibly overlooked that even the Lakers organization failed to show him his respect before they were prompted to do so. In May of 2011, the Lakers had already built statues outside of the Staples Center of Magic Johnson, Jerry West, Chick Hearn, Oscar De La Hoya, and Wayne Gretzky. Those were all well-deserved, but the lack of Kareem getting his own statue more than 20 years after his retirement was one of the biggest oversights in Lakers history. It was in May of 2011 that Kareem shared his strong feelings on the matter when he said, "I don't understand it. It's either an oversight or they're taking me for granted. I'm not going to try to read people's minds, but it doesn't make me happy. It's definitely a slight. I feel slighted." It was soon afterwards the Lakers finally made a statue in Kareem's honor. Despite the oversights of Kareem's prestigious career, he was GOAT quality from the instant he entered the NBA. As a rookie, he improved the Bucks by 29 wins while averaging 29 points and 15 rebounds. Take a second to ponder what I just said. Imagine a player in today's day entering the NBA as a rookie, improving his team by 29 games and averaging 29 and 15. If Zion Williamson did that next season, this hype generation of social media would already be saying that he's on track to be the greatest ever. That's how good Kareem was right from the start. In only his sophomore season, Kareem was averaging 31 points and 16 rebounds and led the Bucks to win 66 games. His second year in the league was impressive enough for him to secure the first of 6 MVP awards. That season, they went on to the NBA Finals and swept the Baltimore Bullets, which resulted in a Finals MVP for Kareem. By the end of only his second season in the NBA, Kareem was an MVP and Finals MVP who averaged 31 and 16. Again, just imagine if Zion Williamson did that in only his second season. The guy would own the basketball world with that kind of introduction to his career. By 1975, Kareem was ready to move on from Milwaukee and demanded a trade to either the LA Lakers or the New York Knicks. He was then traded to the Lakers, and it was then that he began the half of his career that he's most remembered for. In his first season with the Lakers in the 1975-76 season, Kareem had one of the greatest single seasons of NBA history. He averaged 27.7 points, 16.9 rebounds, and a monstrous 4.1 blocks per game. His total of 1,111 defensive rebounds that season is an NBA record that still stands more than 4 decades later. His season was so impressive that he was named MVP of the league that year, despite the fact that the Lakers didn't even make the playoffs. Kareem would continue to be the staple of consistency as him and Magic dominated the NBA throughout the 1980s. Something to remember about Kareem is that he was the perfect center to be paired with Magic Johnson. When choosing your all-time starting five, if Magic is your point guard, then you must certainly take Kareem at the center position, because Magic loved to run the fast break and push the tempo, and very few centers in NBA history could run the floor with Magic as well as Kareem did. Kareem's skyhook was arguably the most indefensible shot in NBA history. I mean, think about it this way. Every time Kareem was in the post with his back to the basket, his defender knew what was coming. We all did. And yet there was still absolutely nothing he could do to stop it. You had a player who was 7 foot 2 inches tall, who had a 7 foot 5 inch wingspan, who could leap like he was taking a jump shot and would put the ball sky high in the air before flicking his wrist for an almost certain 2 points. Also consider the fact that his non-shooting shoulder was facing the defender, meaning the defensive player would have to try to go across Kareem's body just to contest the shot. This is why the skyhook is the most indefensible shot in NBA history, and it's also why Kareem is the NBA's all-time leading scorer. Honestly, one of the biggest travesties of the modern NBA is that no centers are taking the time to learn the skyhook. But it is an incredibly difficult shot to learn, and a technique that Kareem practiced since he was only 9 years old. Kareem may have been the hardest player to guard that there's ever been. He scored more points than any player in NBA history, he won more MVP awards than any player in NBA history, and he won 6 NBA championships. This is why Kareem Abdul-Jabbar is the greatest player of all time. Thanks for watching my video as always, guys. This is video number 4 of 6 in my GOAT series. Feel free to check out the other videos I've made so far in my GOAT series. Next up is LeBron James and Michael Jordan. Make sure to stay tuned for those. Make sure to like, subscribe, and hit that bell for notifications. Appreciate all of your guys' support, and I'll see you guys in the next video.